before there was the movie Charlie's Angels, there was the groundbreaking television series where Kate Jackson played the brainy beauty Sabrina Duncan. And since then, yeah, she's been an accomplished actress who had to deal with some real life dramas of her own. Please welcome Kate Jackson.
I wanted to be
sitting here for ever since you've come on the air, I'm so happy to be here.
And we're thrilled you're here.
Well, thank you very
and
much.
And we want to know if there's going to be a reunion of the original Charlie's Angels.
Yeah.
Everybody wants to know, you and Farrah and Jacqueline Smith.
You know, Farrah and I started talking about it last year, and then we brought Jacqueline in on it, and now if we can get our schedule. Oh, I saw a picture. If we can get our schedules together.
You're going to do it?
We're going to do it.
Yes. Oh,
that's
it.
After, you know, I've heard a rumor that there were two really movies.
But the first one was really excellent. The second one was, whatever.
Yeah, now,
well, you guys should have been in it at least a little bit.
Right?
You weren't in it at all.
Yeah, that's what I couldn't understand,
they
how they could have a Charlie's Angels movie and Charlie's Angels not be in it.
Yeah.
I didn't get that.
Well, Jacqueline made a little cameo.
She did.
Made a cameo.
In the second one.
All right, well, now there's a TV movie about the behind the scenes of Charlie's Angels, I think it is.
Yeah, I heard that.
And there's a young actress, Lauren Stamley, do you know her?
I do not know her except by email.
Okay, and so she's going to be you.
Wow.
She's going to try to be you.
Come on. She's a pretty girl.
Yeah,
pretty.
Absolutely. So what do you think of that?
Well, I think it's weird. I think it's very strange. And I think it's really sort of scary that three more people are going to pretend to be Charlie's Angels.
Right. What do you think the appeal is? Because it's never lost its appeal.
I have no idea. That show just seemed to hit everybody when everybody was happy and having a good time and loving their lives. We meant for it to show that women can do everything that men can do, and they can be smart and pretty, and they can run and jump and say freeze and do those things.
And isn't it also supposed to focus on the fact that, you know, Farrah Fawcett left after the first season and maybe centralize on that theme? I mean, did that drama really happen, or were things that spread behind the scene? Is it all hype?
This thing that's going to come on, whatever network it's going to come on, they should be ashamed of themselves. Nobody talked to anybody about anything. They don't know. They don't know what happened. Farrah never had a contract. She never signed
her contract.
No, she never signed her contract the first year because she had already done that famous poster.
Oh.
And Spelling Goldberg, the producers of our show, have enough money as it is, wanted a percentage of that poster. They wanted part of her merchandising. And she said, no, I did that before this whole thing came about.
Really?
So she never signed her contract. So when she left after the first year, she wasn't walking out on a contract. She didn't have one.
And you know, no one ever tells the backstory. Everybody always wants to make their own story up like that.
Instead,
she looked out for herself, like the character she was supposed to be playing on the show.
She sure did.
And if you wanted to flip your hair up like her, would they have allowed that? What if you wanted to wear your hair like Farrah wore it?
If I couldn't.
You couldn't.
My hair wouldn't do that.
Everybody else in the country did.
Yes,
that's true.
But you know, turning to a more serious topic, I mean, I don't think many people know. I mean, you look so healthy and so beautiful, but you had some very serious heart surgery not too long ago.
I did. I was born with a hole in my heart, an ASD, and this was, now they, you know, they operate on little tiny babies and fix it, but when I was born, which was a little longer ago than yesterday, they didn't do that. So,
and you didn't even know yet.
No, I didn't know until eight years ago, and it was discovered just by fluke, and it wasn't as if I had never been to the doctor. But my dear friend, Dr. Gerald Pohost, who's the head of cardiology at USC now, discovered it with his stethoscope, and I had open heart surgery.
Wow.
Which brought me to the American Heart Association and brings me here today to talk about women and heart disease, something that I'm passionate about, because I discovered a statistic when I was spokesperson for the American Heart Association last year, the Power of Love campaign, that one out of every two women will die of heart attack or cardiovascular disease, including stroke, and only one out of every 10 women know that. Mm-hmm. And that just floored me. So I said, we got to change
that. That must be why I'm happy to announce that you're the paid spokesperson for a new campaign called Open The Door to a Healthy Heart.
Yeah. Tell them to pay me more because they don't pay me much. Uh-huh. But it's called Open the Door to a Healthy Heart. And what it really means is open your refrigerator door, look in there. What's in your refrigerator is in your heart. If you've got butter in there instead of squeeze margarine or that spray margarine, if you've got meat with fat on it, and if you have ice cream instead of sherbet, you've probably got plaque, which is a waxy substance in your arteries, in your heart, and you're probably your heart. Just cover your heart's eyes when you open your refrigerator door.
What's in your refrigerator right now?
Well, there's chicken.
No,
she's not. She's a friend of mine. Don't you say that. There's some trouble here.
Together. Kate and I did a show called Baby Boom, a sitcom.
We did.
Years ago, 1991 or something.
You were a German nanny.
And I played a German nanny. Is that the worst casting? I'm going to bring a picture.
Please, Helga.
Her name was Helga. I had braids up here. I wore a white uniform.
And my name was something Wyatt.
I don't even remember your name. I took lessons to learn how to speak with a German accent. It was like a Brooklyn German accent.
So you took care of her baby in the show?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
You were Val Brooker.
I was Helga. I was a ridiculous casting. Helga.
And she was supposed to be, you were very stern and mean.
I was stern, yeah.
Yeah, you were very stern.
Yeah.
I'm doing it right now.
Very good.
I sense another reunion coming up.
Yes. I don't know, but I sense it.
Jackson. Oh, yeah. If you would like more information on women and heart disease, you can check our website. We'll be right back.